After listening to the Dhamma from the Buddha, Sirima became a sotapanna, a stream enterer. She was no longer willing to continue as a courtesan, and instead dedicated all of her time to looking after the order of monks, called the Sangha, and to performing other meritorious deeds. She invited the Sangha to send 8 monks to her house every day for their meals. She gave them meal vouchers that they could pass out to other monks back at the temple. She always served the monks who came to her house with her own hands, and her food offerings were so abundant that each portion would have been enough for 3 or 4 people. One day, one of the 8 monks who had eaten at Sirima's house went back to his monastery. When he arrived there, the other monks asked him about whether there was enough to eat. He explained that the portions were large enough that his bowl almost overflowed. When they asked about the quality of the food, he said that it was indescribable. He had never tasted such exquisite food. However, he then added that nothing he experienced that day could hold a candle to the beauty of the hostess. Sirima's beauty was incomparable. She was graceful and radiant. This piqued the interest of one of the young monks who began to feel hot inside. He started to imagine how beautiful she must be if she left such an impression on the other monk. He began to fall in love with the woman he'd yet to meet. He began to inquire about how he could get a lunch voucher for Sirima's house. The young, lovesick monk was able to trade favors and swapped vouchers with someone so he could go on the very next day. He couldn't bear to wait even one more day. On that day, Sirima became very ill, removed all her finery, and went to bed. When the lovesick young monk arrived at her house, he was greeted by servants. The servants offered the meal to the monks as well. The lovesick monk became angry and extremely disappointed. Once Sirima heard that the monks had started eating, she made an effort to pay her respects to the monks. She asked her servants to help her as she painfully made her way to the main room. She was so weak that her whole body shook and sweat dripped from her body. When the young lovesick monk saw her, he thought, "She looks radiantly beautiful even when she is ill. Imagine how beautiful she would be if she were well and dressed in all her finery." Overcome with passion, the young monk closed his alms bowl without taking a single bite. After the meal, the monk wandered back to the monastery with his bowl. He kept the bowl covered and lay down on his bed, replaying Sirima's image in his mind. The more he thought about her, the more beautiful she became to him. His friends tried to get him to eat something, but they did not succeed. Sirima passed away from her illness that night. When King Pimpisara found out, he had a message sent to the Buddha. "Venerable Sir, Sirima, the sister of your personal physician Chiwaka, has died." The Buddha sent the king a message. The body was not to be cremated, but instead placed in the charnel ground. There, it was to be guarded to prevent carrion crows and other beasts from devouring it. After 3 days, the body had putrefied. It became swollen and was crawling with worms. On On the word of the Buddha, King Bimbisara decreed that all adult males of Rajagaha were to walk past the body to see Sirima in her current condition. Anyone who refused would be punished with a fine of 8 gold coins. The lovesick monk had not eaten in 4 days, and the food in his bowl was now also crawling with worms. His friend came to him and said, "Brother, the Buddha is going to see Sirima." At the word Sirima, the monk felt his energy return to him. He jumped up and emptied and rinsed his bowl. As he was emptying his bowl, the image of worms crawling in his food from Sirima's house remained in the back of his mind. The young monk rushed to get in line to see Sirima. At the charnel grounds, a large crowd had gathered. The Buddha sat with his monks to one side and the nuns on another, followed by the king and his retinue, and then the male and female devotees. The Buddha asked,
"Great king, who is this?"
"Chiwaka's sister, sir, Sirima by name."
The Buddha then said,
"Let it be known, anyone who pays the sum of 1,000 gold coins, the cost of a night with Sirima, may have her."
Not a single man raised a hand.
"Then for 500.
Silence.
"For 100.
Nobody moved.
"For 50 coins.
Silence.
"For 1 coin.
Nothing.
"For free.
Still no one showed any interest.
"See here, monks. You see a woman who was the object of desire for all men. In this same city, the same men that see her now would have paid more than 1,000 gold coins to merely spend one night with her. Now, however, no one will have her, even for free. This is what happens to all bodies. Our bodies are temporary, fragile, and only made attractive through ornaments, clothes, and perfumes. Yet nothing can stop this body from aging, becoming sick, and eventually dying. Only fools attach themselves to fantasies and see what is filthy as beautiful and desirable."
The young lovesick monk, listening in the crowd, put all this together in his mind. When it was alive, Sirima's body was beautiful and desirable, just like the food in his bowl when it was freshly cooked and served. However, over time, the food in his bowl rotted and the bowl filled with worms and became swarmed by flies. Similarly, once the life left Sirima's body, it became bloated, filled with worms, leaked fluids, and was swarmed by flies and other animals. Upon contemplation of his own body, he understood that he was no different. In fact, nothing in this world could resist deterioration. Therefore, there was nothing worth attaching oneself or one's fantasies to. With this newfound wisdom, he became an arahan.
What do you think the moral of this story is?
We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.